Hey guys, welcome back to another video on the channel, and this one is going to be all about the new updated turrets in HBM Small. So I previously did a video on turrets, but the thing is that the old turrets have now been removed permanently from this mod, and a lot of new turrets have been added, and along with them comes new mechanisms and new ammunitions for these turrets. So in this video we are gonna go over all of them, and this video is gonna be a long one, so make sure to use timestamps if you want to skip to a specific turret. So without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So the first turret that we are gonna check out today, guys, is the heavy machine gun turret called Chekhov's gun. And like the Chekhov's gun, all the other turrets in this mod are crafted using an assembly machine. So once placed, the heavy machine gun turret is gonna look something like this. And in order to craft this, as I told you before, you are gonna need the assembly machine and also the assembly template for the heavy machine gun turret. Now these templates are gonna change for each respective turrets. Now these templates will tell you all the raw materials that you need. And once you place all these materials like this, there, the assembly machine will craft you the turret that you need. So let's check the GUI of these turrets, as it is vastly different from what it used to be for the previous turrets. And it looks way cooler in my opinion. So now if you right click on the turret, this is how the GUI of the turret is gonna look like. First of all, there is an on and off switch here, and there is a chip with four modes available. So the first is player mode, the second is the neutral mobs mode, the third is the monster mode, and finally fourth is the machine mode. These are all the different targeting mechanisms, and here is the slot for the ammo, and finally the internal energy buffer of 10 kilo HE. So this chip right here is important if you are gonna use the turrets on a server. Let me show you why. So first things first, let's collect the turret like this with a cable, and it should be full with power. Now if I select the player mode on this turret like this, hold on. So if I start the turret, nothing is gonna happen. But if I go ahead and select the player mode like this, this turret is gonna target me, and that can be very dangerous if you are playing in survival and you are on a server, as you don't want to die through your own turret. So the turret will keep me locked on. So yeah. Now in order to avoid this, what you are gonna need is the turret AI chip, and this process is gonna be the same for all the other turrets in this video. So in order to craft the turret AI chip, you are gonna need 6 gold wires, 2 overclock circuit and 1 polymer bar. Now with the turret chip in hand, shift right click to add your player data, and then place this chip here, and that will tell the turret that now you are the owner of this turret, and it will no longer target you. It will target the other players and mobs. So now that we have placed the chip, this is how you are gonna use it. We are gonna check out how this turret works and how it fires. So the ammunition for this turret is gonna be the 50 BMG bullets. And there are a lot of different variants available for the 50 BMG bullets. But first things first, we are gonna just take normal 50 BMG bullets, and then we are gonna spawn in some creepers. So take your bullets like this and place them here. And then now as we have selected the monster mobs, so we are gonna get some creepers, and here let's spawn them in and see how much damage it does. There. So each round is doing nearly 16 to 17 damage. That is quite a lot. Now let's select the neutral mobs mod, and now this turret is also gonna attack the villagers. This is something that was not there before, but Bob changed it. So now let's spawn in some villagers, and yeah, let the slaughter begin. So as you can see, this turret has a decent rate of fire, not very fast, but it has really high damage. So yeah, now there are a lot of different types of bullets, as I told you guys. So these are all the variants available. We have the incendiary rounds. We also have the phosphorus rounds, also there are the explosives, the DU rounds, the armor piercing rounds, and also many others. So you can try these rounds out for yourself, and yeah, have fun with them. Now the second turret that we are gonna check out is gonna be the Mr. Friendly turret. Now it is a smaller version of the heavy machine gun turret, and this turret uses the 5 mm rounds instead of the 50 BMG rounds. But yeah, it is kinda similar to the heavy machine gun turret that we checked out before. So this is how the turret looks like, and it also has a similar GUI as the heavy machine gun turret. Here goes the ammo. So let's first place our ownership chip. And then let's also get some 5 mm rounds for this turret. Now there are also different variants for the 5 mm rounds. We have the explosive rounds, the DU rounds, the star metal, and also the chlorified rounds. So let's get the normal 5 mm rounds and place them like this, and then select the mobs mode. So as you can see, this turret doesn't do a lot of damage, but it has pretty fast rate of fire, so that's pretty good. So this turret is ideal for like defending your base or anything like that from neutral or passive mobs. So now that we have checked out the normal rounds, let's also check out the explosive rounds. And the explosive rounds will, yeah, as the name suggests, will deal explosive damage. It will also damage the terrain around you. So yeah, that was it for the Mr. Friendly turret. Now the third turret we are checking today is the autocannon Jeremy. Now this turret is pretty damn big. As you can see, it is probably the biggest turret that we have checked out of all three of them, and for good reason. It fires 240 mm shells, and there are 5 types of them. The normal shell, we then have the high explosive shells, 2 armor penetrating shells, and finally the nuclear warhead shells. So first, let's only fire the normal 240 mm shells. Now these shells deal a lot of damage, so it's mostly one shot one kill for most of the mobs if they don't have a lot of armor or HP. So let's fire it. Now also the reload sound of this turret is pretty cool compared to all the other turrets. And yeah, now let's try out the nuclear warhead shell. But in order to try this out safely so that I don't destroy my own base, I'm gonna use a turret controller. Now the thing is, the turret controller is not available in creative inventory, and it also has no crafting recipe. So in order to obtain it, you have to use not enough items. But yeah, the turret controller can be used to manually control the turret. So let's place in a nuclear warhead and then shift click with your turret controller. Bam. So as you can see, each shot will deal a ton of damage and will also destroy a lot of blocks if fired on the ground basically. But it also has the power to destroy a lot of the strong blocks. So yeah, that was it for Jeremy. Now the fourth turret that we are checking out today is the Tawon turret, which is the prototype turret. Now this turret probably has the maximum amount of damage out of all the turrets that we have checked out, and the ammo for this turret is gonna be the depleted uranium 235 box. Now each shot will consume one uranium 235 box, which can be crafted by steel plates and the depleted uranium 235 rods. Like this. So yeah, once you have the ammo, place it in like this. And also one another thing, that this turret also has the highest range or the longest range out of all the turrets that we checked out so far. It can snipe mobs or players from pretty far away, so it makes for an ideal tower turret, the kind that you would place on the highest point of your base. You can see it's literally like one shot one kill, and this turret is also pretty fast, but running it is also very expensive. So yeah, this is the Tawon turret. Each shot will consume one box of ammo. So in order to check out the damage properly, let's spawn a mob which has a lot of HP. So yeah, let's go for an iron golem. And let's see how much damage each turret shot or each tower shot will do to the iron golem. And damn, would you look at that speed. So this turret nearly does 33, 34 damage per shot, which is quite a lot actually. So yeah, that was it for the tower turret. So now let's move on to the next turret, which is gonna be the rocket launcher turret, Richard. Now this turret was newly added in the mob, and as you can see, we can see through the turret right now. But wait and see what happens once we load this turret up with the shells. So the ammo for this turret is gonna be the 84mm rockets, and there are a lot of variants available as you can see on the screen right here. We have the red glare, the EMP, the chemical, phosphorus, rocket, IFR&D, and also the nuclear warheads. So these 84mm rockets are the ammo, and it can take all of them. But yeah, for now, let's use the normal 84mm rockets. Now once you place the rockets like this, as you can see, first we could see through the turret. Now we actually can. Let me get down. And yeah, as you can see, we can instead see the tips of the rocket that we just placed. So that is a really good detail in my opinion. So now that we have placed the rocket turret there, let's get in some volunteers. So this turret is gonna deal a lot of damage, but sadly it doesn't have a lot of range. So it's good for protecting your base against high armor mobs. So yeah, that was it for the rocket turret Richard. Now the next turret is the goalkeeper twin Howard, which is the CIWS turret. Now this turret replaced the Phalanx MK15, which used to be in the mob earlier, in order to protect your base from missiles. Now in order to arm this turret, you need the 200 belt round ammunition, and once you have that, start placing it like this. So this turret works best against missiles, so it's best to use it on machine mode rather than on any other mobs or anything like that. It kills missiles pretty fast compared to all the other turrets. Actually, the other turrets can only lock onto the missiles. They can't really keep up with the speed. So now, make sure that this machine mode is selected, and I'm gonna fire the missile and see what happens. Bam. So as you can see, this missile was destroyed before it could hit its target due to the CIWS turret. Now I have made an entire video on the CIWS system. I'm gonna link it in the description if you wanna check it out in detail. Now I have saved the best turret for the last, and a final turret for this video is gonna be, no, the second final turret, I'm sorry. So the second final turret is gonna be the flamethrower turret, which is Fritz. And in order to arm this turret, you are gonna need a lot of diesel tanks and the diesel fluid identifier. So place your fluid identifier and start placing your diesel tanks in like this, and the internal buffer for diesel will go up. Now this turret doesn't have a lot of range, but it does a lot of close range damage. So it's good for base defense once again, when you are fighting against close proximity mobs. So as soon as it detects its target, it's gonna fire up a lot of diesel that we placed in, and yeah, do a lot of area damage. So that's why it is good for base defense like this. Consumes diesel at a pretty decent rate. So yeah, this was the flamethrower turret Fritz. And finally, the best turret which I saved for the last is gonna be the high energy maser turret called Maxwell. Now this turret basically makes any mob go splash. They literally explode. It is a pretty gold turret, so yeah, you guys have been warned. Like this. So what it does is basically it locks onto a mob, and then after blasting it with energy, bam, they go splash. So now I'm just gonna spawn in a couple of villagers, and you guys enjoy making villager smoothie. So that was all I had for this video, guys. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, do smash that like button and also subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Peace out.